Hi lads and lasses, Modest Pelican here with Red Dead Redemption 2. If you enjoy this video, please commit a crime severe enough so that you go to jail, and then convince your fellow prisoners to subscribe to me once they get out. It's sort of like how prison gangs recruit their members, but instead of going on to push crack and kill people, they'll be going on to watch an aquatic bird play video games and tell people to stay hydrated, as this really helps spread the good word of my channel. So I load in and spawn next to a river, which is great, as it's my third favourite body of water. I'm still wearing this stupid hat I bought, and I'm still riding my unfit, chain-smoking horse that can barely trot 25 metres before it has a coronary spasm and keels over and dies. So yeah, we're not exactly Cowboy of the Year, but if we can get some new clothes, weapons, and maybe level up a bit, we could transform from a shitty cowboy into a slightly less shitty cowboy, which would be a real success story. While I'm waiting for my mate Stealth-O-Mato to join, I stumble across a 3-star Western Moose, which we will call Millie. That's just a random name, and a complete coincidence that a girl called Millie never responded to my messages after I paid for an expensive dinner for her like 7 years ago. I'm not that petty, but yeah. Anyway, I track down Millie the Moose, and I don't know who this gold-digging thot, I mean wild animal, thinks they are, bloody Michael Phelps or something, but you can't get away from me twice, because this time I have a bow and arrow. Stealth-O-Mato then proceeds to start shooting Millie the Moose with his rifle, ruining the 3-star pelt and scaring her away, which is just classic Mato. Like, are you right, mate? I'm trying to hunt and potentially get some emotional closure here. I proceed to shoot Mato in the head with an arrow, which inevitably enrages him. Luckily, I can deal with him as I'm an ace shot with the bow and arrow. Just kidding, Mato domes me with his rifle and we call a truce. Nothing rebuilds trust walls like some waterfall fishing, and I love this about Red Dead Online. 1 minute you're committing first degree murder, and the next you're deciding what bait would work best at a fishing spot. As it turns out, Mato is much better than me at fishing, but he is probably using Chinese hacks, I mean any nationality hacks. I then remember that there is no problem a gun can't solve, and so I just shoot the fish with my cattleman's revolver. You can keep your 8-kilogram musky fish, Stealth-O Virgino, while me and the boys feed off this tiny pickerel for weeks. So we ride out, but I have a small problem. I must be the least honourable cowboy in Westeros. You see, as many of you know, I love massacring NPC civilians, which is apparently really frowned upon around here. So I'm going to try, like, reasonably hard to be more honourable. Anyway, we stumble across a cute little cottage and no one's home, so we head inside and steal all of their canned vegetables. Not a great start to the whole being more honourable mantra. Like, imagine when the poor old owner gets home and wants to make a cup of soup and they can't. We are worse than the devil. We also torch the house, and so we decide that we'll start with a fresh, clean, honourable slate from now. We ride on through the night and approach a small town, and it's probably the sketchiest town I've ever seen in my life. I feel like someone's about to stab me and harvest my organs, so it's sort of like Detroit, except a lot safer. We stock up on ammunition, and I must say I don't like the cut of this man's jib. Unfortunately, the game won't let me shoot him in the head, and so I come up with a cunning plan. We'll light Mato on fire, and he will run in and burn the shopkeeper. As you can imagine, Mato isn't a huge fan of this plan, but I talk him around, and I must say I admire his commitment to the team. Sadly though, it doesn't work out, which is good for our honour rating, but bad for Mato's skin complexion. We decide to stop for a beer, God knows we've earned it. Well, we haven't really, but anyway, this leads to a mass brawl, and this joker has the audacity to knock my sexually confused hat off. Nobody insults my hat but me, and so I beat him to a pulp to teach him a lesson. I also beat this guy up for literally no reason, but like I'm sure he was thinking bad things about my hat, maybe. Anyway, Mato wants to sell his fish, and so we ride off to find a butcher, but immediately realise that we can't be bothered riding all the way there, and so we head towards the train station. Now, I don't want to say that Mato is a psychopath, but purposely parking your horse on the tracks so that it gets Randy Ortoned by a train would suggest as much. It rolls past, and it's full of players who are all marked as red toxic little griefers, and they start shooting at Mato, and so we heroically ride after the train. I don't know why, but trains are always just so cool in video games. Maybe I should just start making content on Train Simulator 2019 and become a train channel. We move up the train cars, and Mato is slain by a dodgy malacca known as Dr. Bunghole Bob. Now, no one kills my friends but me. It's a bit of an awkward fight, but I do my best. Bunghole Bob clearly has good aim, but also clearly has questionable decision making when picking game attacks. I throw fire bottles at them, and it's honestly quite strange to be using these in an actual fight and not just to torch civilians. Anyway, if we can steal this train, we can humiliate Bunghole and his boys. Eventually, one of the lads peeks, and so I blast him with my shotgun. Using this brief momentum, I opt for the power play and am immediately gunned down by Dr. Bunghole Bob. You know what? I don't even think he's an actual doctor. We ride after the train, but we are a pretty easy target for them as we have no cover and are basically a collateral headshot waiting to happen. It'd be pretty handy if we had two horses, hey Marto? Surprisingly, I managed to somehow land a headshot on the good doctor as we slowly but surely clear these gangbangers off the train. This is actually like the Wild West version of that iconic Big Smoke mission. We end up in this weird fight where they're killing us and we're killing them back, and we're all just respawning in this forest, but it occurs to us that now would be a great time to steal the train. You see, as they shot us first, we can see them on the map all the time, but they can only see us when we are very close by, and so we can sneak away. We decide to act now and tactically slide down the hill so that we can mount up and make a play. I head towards where I'm guessing the train is, and the tunnel gets darker than my mates and my group chats. I pull out my lantern, but then Marto calls for help in a stressed state. As I'm leaving the tunnel to assist him, it sort of looks like I'm ascending to heaven. I'm actually pretty stoked I get to go to heaven because I didn't even have to perform a suicide bombing. I wonder what's in heaven anyway, and so I leave the tunnel, and it turns out heaven is just Marto being molested by a grizzly bear, just like the Bible said. Not ideal timing, as we've got an angry gang chasing us down, but I tell Marto to serpentine as I come in and do what Bear Grylls would have done. Shoot the bear multiple times with a shotgun and then drink my own urine for like no reason. Seriously, I swear Bear Grylls is trying to drink his own urine sometimes. Like there could be a freshwater river 50 meters away and he would still opt for his urine. He probably drinks it at home and serves it to his dinner guests with bloody ice cubes for God's sake. Anyway, we catch up to the train and it looks like the driver has taken off somewhere, so we climb aboard and roll out. The trains really do bring people together. Like only at an inner city train station will you see a middle class office worker buying what they think is premium weed but is actually oregano off a 14-year-old Eshe Chav lad. Now I don't know what came over me, but I decided to send it, but you see the physics in Red Dead are pretty damn good, and so instead of hitting the water, my momentum carried me across the riverbank and well, yeah. Not to be outdone, Marto then jumped for the water too, but he died upon impact. Needless to say, your boys won't be winning gold medal for synchronized diving at the 2020 Tokyo Olympics. Anyway, as fun as trains are, we need to start making some progress. We find an outlaw camp, shoot all of the outlaws, and then untie this woman who was being held prisoner 50 Shades of Grey style. Now saving her will help with our honor rating, so we decide to do the good deed and take her back to Valentine. I mean, Marto tries to push her off the edge of this cliff first, but he couldn't do it, so she's pretty lucky. We drop her back safe to the sheriff's office and are paid $4.80, and our honor slider doesn't move at all. You know what? Being the good guy, I'm going back to my casual murdering ways. While in Valentine, I also buy a new hat and outfit so that I can strike fear into my opponents. Not really sure how a blue cap does that, but at least it's an improvement upon my previous purchase, and I'm now clearly the best dressed lad in Middle Earth. We head back to camp and realize that we don't even have Marto's fish anymore. It's a pretty sad moment, as he loved that fish like a son. Poor guy, but ah well, nothing lightens up a sad mood like a little bit of slapstick comedy, and so I use one of my explosive arrows to kill him and his horse, which predictably doesn't make him feel any better at all. He starts cooking anyway, right next to his body and the decaying charred horse, and I mean, I'm no health inspector, but that can't be hygienic. I know you're sad, mate, but seriously, get the fuck off my stool, that's where I sit and ponder, not where you sit and ponder. Anyway, as good as explosive arrows are for annoying my friends, they are also quite handy for missions, and so we sign up for a few assassination jobs. It's quite satisfying watching the helpless targets pull out their little rusty revolvers while I shoot dynamite arrows at them that are far more effective. Following the successful mission, we find ourselves in the city, and I spot a girl who could definitely be my future wife. Of course though, Marto guns her down, which is a total cockblock. I'm pretty distraught as I think I loved that woman, but by some divine intervention she seems to have clung to life despite being shot, and then Marto shoots her again. Seriously, picking up girls with this guy is a nightmare. I wish I could tell you the disrespect finished there, but then he dismounts the horse and puts on the deceased lady's hat. Wow, that is so wrong on so many levels, but you also can't deny he looks damn good in that hat. Moments later, we come across a hunter who has been hunting alligators, but he can't carry all of the skins, and so we decide to help transport them back into town. Unfortunately, he rides off before we can properly communicate this, but we make it our mission to get this man his goddamn alligator skins. We ride after him, but accidentally ride into World War III as two gangs fight it out in the fields of Azeroth. None of these guys are the original hunter, but we'll just give them the skins to be nice, and they can clearly see we're no threat, so we'll just quickly drop them off before this gang fight escalates too much. Stealth-O-Mato then proceeds to shoot one of them, and I am instantly gunned down. I know we're a team, but you've got to admit, Stealth-O-Mato is one trigger-happy malacca. Well, if these guys aren't going to accept the alligator skins, we will just have to find someone else. We forge forward, and the thunderstorm raging on sure does make this alligator skin delivery mission seem far more epic than it really is. Eventually, we find someone, and they turn out to be Crocodile Dundee. Seriously, with this lightning coming down, I feel like I am returning Thor's hammer or something, but in reality, I am just giving this random dude a good alligator skin. And that's not even the top tier of alligator skins. I celebrate completing the quest we made up by having a little row, but of course Mato is on shore trying to put holes in my boat. Eventually we all pile in, even Crocodile Dundee for some reason, and we row for a better place. A place where Mato doesn't shoot literally everything he sees. A place where the girls I fall in love with don't also get shot by Mato. A place where the grass is greener, where the weed is danker, where the water is purer. But nope, apparently if you row out too far, your boat automatically sinks, and as it turns out, none of us are as strong at swimming as Millie the Moose was. The moral of this story is don't pay for your date's dinner. Thanks for watching, you absolute legends, and a massive thank you to my patrons for supporting me and who really are the backbone of my channel and make this content possible. Have a great weekend, and until next time, and as always, stay classy.